Hey skiers, it's Bob with SkiEssentials.com. Welcome to our 2022 ski test. We've got a Liberty Evolve 90 women's ski for you today. A really well-rounded, versatile, all-mountain ski. Definitely has more of a preference for carved turns and groomed terrain, but the width and that nice flex in the shovel do make it easier to get in any off-piste or adventurous type of skiing. But kind of the shape and the build of these leans more to the front side, leans more to groomers, nice wide sweeping turns. We've really liked these skis in the past, and they've added some new stuff to it for this year that takes that carving performance to the next level. So they use their VMT 3.0 core in this ski. So whereas before it had two stringers of metal, now we get three. And that's what we used to see in the V series skis, which have now just merged with the Evolve series. So they've taken that third metal strut and added it to this ski here. So they use a blend of bamboo, poplar, and paulownia wood in these skis, keeping it a nice blend of lightweight and energy. And then those three vertical metal struts add the power and the dampness and the responsiveness of this ski. They do a great job. You know, having that metal in a vertical application really keeps this thing smooth and damp and quiet. That's probably the quality that sticks out the most with these, is just how quiet they are in a carved turn. And then, like we see from the other Evolve series skis and what we saw in the V series in years past, is a pretty on-trail, pretty much on-trail specific camber profile. So we do get some positive camber underfoot with about 10% tip rocker. You know, there's very minimal taper. You know, that ski, the edges go right out to the very tips of the ski. That makes a long effective edge and adds to that smooth ride. But we don't see a whole lot of tip rocker here, and pretty minimal splay. So it is a pretty low profile tip. Same can be said for the tail. We see that very flat shape to the end of the tail. And again, that taper shape goes right off to the ends, allowing for that longer effective edge contact. And minimal rocker as well, very little splay. So that is what makes this ski perform stronger on a groomed trail and in a carved turn, is that these tails really like to bite in and hold on to the edge. You can release them just because of the lack of horizontal metal. So it does still allow the skis to flex pretty naturally. But you do have to be a little bit on it, especially with that third metal strut in there. Does make a difference in terms of how you're going to bend the ski and how it's going to react. So it is an upgrade in performance, does make the ski a little bit more demanding. But overall, the blend with the wood core makes it just, you know, easier overall than something with two full sheets of metal. We also get two strips of carbon in the construction as well. So that does add some lightness and energy to the ski. But really well-rounded, you know, definitely looking to put an advanced and expert skier on this thing, just because they're going to be able to access the full performance. This one is the 165. We're looking at a 15.5 meter turn radius. So it's a little bit on the short side. You do want to be on it and just be able to, you know, really use the ski from tip to tail, that whole edge. If you're able to do that, you're going to get a very smooth feeling ski with just the most damp and quiet feeling that we've seen on a ski like this. Very impressive what Liberty does, and we're all for it. So check this thing out at SkiEssentials.com, and we'll see you out there on the hill. Bye.